Hello, Dominators. Domination tips. Right back with the next, let's farm. Base review, sorry. With the next base review episode. It's last but not least, because there were some important projects I wanted to release between. But nevertheless, I did not forget you, my friend. Raj, I think your name is Raj from War Machine 2. I promised you to go for your base and give you a visit, and now we will do this. First, let's check out our World War. We have again a very big concern, a very strong enemy alliance in World War. Let's see, let's scout the bases. That's the first one. Pretty high walls. You see most of the walls even level 11 as well as level 12. Also some level 10 and level 9 walls, I don't know. But we have a strong, an okay, let's call it okay, Forbidden City layout. Everything is global age maxed, except for some buildings, like this tower, the fourth stable. He has four stables due to atomic age. So three maxed out global stables here, and one, I think it's a classical age stable. Then three level 30 generals, very big concern for me. I won't tell now my strategy, because... probably Gabo. It's just only a little risk, but it could be yes, could be a chance that also Gabo looks at this video. And when I now tell my complete strategy, and indeed I have a strategy, and I made a strategy for every of the enemy bases, which is very solid, I think. He could probably change his base, and I don't want to do this, but I can only tell you guys I have a cool strategy for this base, and I will try to do it. This will be my enemy tomorrow. Same over here. Strategy is made. It's very obvious, but I won't tell at this point. I will tell at a later point when the war has begun and nobody can change the base layout anymore. We see over here very many 11 walls as well as level 12 walls. So this guy has his walls even a little bit above my walls. But only his gates are far behind, so his gates are obviously his weak points. Generals are also very, very high. Indeed, a very complex layout he thought about with three sniper towers. Definitely not an easy layout, which David has to go for. Enemy number three. Insane walls. Really insane. Highest walls of our enemy currently in the game. A very, very, very easy layout. I can't tell it in another way. Yes, the defensive buildings are very strong, but there are some ways where you can very easily get to the town center without getting any risk of running into some traps. This guy is dropping his base by unleveling his street. He's only at level 173 and his roads are not built up, but he is definitely global age max, a little bit below global age max, but definitely higher than level 173. It's one of the more easier bases about the enemy. Here we have again some kind of maze layout, but this maze layout has also, like the other maze layout number two, some very severe weaknesses. Which I will uncover when the enemy is unable to react to my video and get rid of these weaknesses. But I can only tell you this base has some severe weaknesses we will use. Enemy number 5 is one of the most concerning enemies. Very high walls and indeed a very good layout with obviously some traps over here and something like this. It looks very properly and we have to deal about this. One of our best Forbidden City players. Wow, it looks awesome with all of these tanks. One of our best Forbidden City players, a real specialist for Forbidden Cities, will keep on Bon? I don't know how its name is. Boo! Will keep on Boo. So, we'll see. Here you see again some kind of maze layout, but it's also definitely not that strong. From levels from enemy number 6 on, the layouts are getting weaker, much and much. I meant more and more. only enemy number 10 is also a good layout, quite good layout. You can crash both centers, but there is some risk about. So we will see. I'm very looking forward for this attack, for this battle, because we have the opportunity to get a stalemate over here. I don't anticipate that we have the chance to win. But I've already wasted 5 minutes and we have to visit some bases. Only a thing I wanted to ask you. I got some severe dislikes below my last video. I used a cut program and I think I cut it. I cut some cool melody in this video, but the feedback wasn't that great. Please tell me why you didn't like it. One of my German subscribers told me that he likes it more when I comment the video and give some background information instead of just simply playing some music. If you think same, please give me in the comment section, and when I know it, I go on commenting the videos instead of playing some music. Some upgrade status before the World War starts. My second bunker gets ready. That's really cool. I have currently 11 people in my university. That means I have a lot of intransparent progress at my base, because the university progress is not manifesting in your level and giving not any XP at all. So my base is leveling up without any transparent factor that you can see that my base gets stronger. But I have most of my people in the university, and that keeps up because I'm leveling currently. I'm going to level my artillery damage, my artillery hit points, my hit points and damage for my Black Watch. So my strongest troops even are getting stronger. To face the global guys we are getting very often. But now let's go into the war machine. We have wasted already enough time. Here we are, War Machine 2, War is the Way. War ready, active players must communicate in chat. A very short but very obvious message. It's War Machine 2, so I think it's a build-up clan, some kind of, or a build-up alliance to form the players, and when they are good enough, they can approach and go for the main alliance. We also therefore see only about 29 members. English is the language, and it's a complete closed alliance. That's probably due to the high request of players who want to get in. The medal count is really relatively low, but we have 17,000 of glory. That's definitely not less, not li a little amount. If you see over here the medal ranking, the highest one is level 159 and only at 1,800 medals. So he obviously seems not to care for league bonus, otherwise he would probably be higher. If we look for the level, we have level 159 below. That means only industrial, also some enlightenment, gunpowder, medieval, and probably 3, 4, 5 classical age players over here. So I think when they are coming to the global age, they are rising up to War Machine 1 clan probably. If we see for the troop donations, we have really good troop donations. My friend Raj, which is the subscriber who requested that I come and visit this alliance, is currently the highest donator. Then we have some others, but in average, a really high donation quote. Same with requests and with lifetime donations. We also have very many. Daddy P, alliance member, alliance leader, is quite the highest one. So I think we will go for Daddy P, Raj, obviously, King James and Electic. So we have very high and players and also some leaders, because leaders are mostly the most active players. And I want to show you some good bases. When we now take the most inactive player, which is at a very low level, we have a really high chance to get a base which is not developed and thought about that much. But if we take an active player who has high donation counts, high level, and a high rank in the alliance, it's very obvious that this guy got all of that statistics only because of his experience in game, and that means his base is also that much better and it's more interesting to look and to analyze this kind of bases. But 10 minutes left already. I have to hurry. Raj. Hello, Raj. Rajesh Kutrapali. Sorry, a little Big Bang Theory joke aside. We see an industrial age player. French guy. Town center is exposed, resource buildings quite inside, very high walls. That's the most obvious point I can see. The base structure I really like about this, because I see some hidden facts which are really cool. But we'll go on and see resource projection we are talking about. So we have three different compartments or chambers in which resources are protected due to the fact that the walls are upgraded very high. He is mainly protecting his gold, and they are all separated. He has also protected one mill as well as his trade goodhouse. Really good choice, I would say. But I see one problem at the beginning. He has his higher mills outside. Why? Your lower mill is inside. Just put your lower mill outside, and it's a little bit increased the effectiveness. And you could also change the location, because if you're attacking from over here, you get two mills very easy. I would just spread them out and put one mill probably over here, so that you have located them all over the base. But that are only small aspects. The gold is protected quite okay, I would call it. But there is a problem, and you can just easily see it. The locations of the gold is quite okay, because all of the gold storage buildings are quite in another chamber. But if you just rally over here, where are no traps at all of these gold buildings can be reached from one single spot. So I think that's a very weak aspect. Because this base layout is very thought about, and we see very high walls and something like this, and some cool other stuff we will talk about later. But the fact that the gold is that easy reachable from one position, I think that's a hard fact to improve your base. Nevertheless, let's go on. I think the next point will be activeness. No, rusher or maxer is the next aspect we have to go about. I see most of the buildings industrial as well as come on, Enlightenment Age. So he's very obviously a maxer. I like this. Activity index. Where are the houses? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Thank you for placing them that obviously, because sometimes I'm too stupid to count them. 7, I think. 7 houses, 8 houses. I don't see the estate, I think. No estate, but we have very many houses, that's cool. And also very high walls. I think 90% out of his walls are at level 11, and only 15, 12 walls over here are at stage 10. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That are nearly only the walls he got new in the industrial age and he has to upgrade afterwards. But there is a very severe factor. We see the gates are very low, because the gates are only at level 11. This one seems to be level 10. Yes, it's level 10, also that one. So his gates are very high weaknesses due to the fact that they have, I think, about 8,000 hit points less than his walls. Upgrade your gates way, way more. Because I am very often highlighting this point. The higher your walls are, the higher the differences in hit points between your walls and your gates are, and that much more you have to compensate by upgrading your gates first. So if your walls are at level 11, you have to keep your gates at stage 14, and they will nevertheless have less hit points than your walls have. I'm really criticizing this base, but only because I see it's a very good base, and the better a base is, the higher is my measure for this base to evaluate. Because at a shitty base or a crappy base, I don't have to analyze that much, because I see most of the buildings were placed without a thought behind. But this guy is obviously really planning, and therefore my expectations are also higher. I don't have anything against you, Raj. Please take this in your mind. Next point. The defensive buildings, the mortars. We see the mortars in a very symmetrical position, located in the center of his base, and they have a good spread around because they are as close as possible together without taking the disadvantage that you can disable two of them or even more with one sabotage. You have to use one sabotage for each mortar. Very perfect position, I would call it. Weakness compensation. It's also really cool, because we see for every mortar at least one cannon tower. This cannon tower can protect two mortars. This one can nearly protect two. Not completely, but it looks like this one is very good protected indeed. This one is also okay protected, and this one is perfectly protected. This one, not perfectly, I would call it from outside, but the locations are very thought about, and we see he placed them not randomly. He chose his positions on purpose, and so it's really good. I think the combinations are quite okay. Air defenses. Where we have the air defenses? One air defense very central, next to the mortars. One is outside, currently being upgraded, and the third air defense is missing, I think. Probably has to. Whoa, my handy. Whoa, sorry, my mobile phone fall down. The third air defense probably is getting researched right now. So one air defense is still missing. One is upgraded to maximum. The second is getting upgraded to maximum. I don't know where the location from this air defense is when it got upgraded, because I think he has placed it outside due to the fact that during the upgrade it's still not active. But this air defense is quite placed very good, because it's inside, it's protected, and the range is that much that you can protect most of your important defensive buildings from air attacks. So quite okay. Currently we have nearly no air defense over here, but I already told you I don't know whether this air defense is placed over here ordinary. Redoubt towers, where we have the redoubts. This redoubt tower is quite okay. It's placed at a corner of the base, and we also have, it's not very close, but we have a gate in the close surrounding. This redoubt is also quite okay, because we have some gates over here, and enemy and defender troops will fluctuate over here. This one is also at a corner with a gate next to it. Raj obviously has viewed or watched many videos of me and followed some of my recommendations. That looks quite great. If you see all these little details he made in his base. Bunkers. Where we have the bunkers? We have two ones, I think. Yes, two ones. One over here and one over here. Both are not upgraded, so industrial beginning. They are both protected. This is quite okay, because we have a cannon tower next to it. I don't know whether traps are here, but when here are some traps, it's perfectly protected. This one is also quite okay, but I don't think that this cannon tower instantly can shoot from over here. One, two, three, four, five. Probably the cannon tower can shoot over here, but the location is quite okay, I think. Sniper tower. The sniper tower is placed very central without taking any disadvantage from the placement, so I think it's also very okay. The sniper tower is not upgraded, so you could probably upgrade it, because this tower is very essential for your defense. Yes. That it was about all defensive buildings. Let's talk about the world wonders, and we have three defensive world wonders. And what I'm currently seeing, no, none of the stables is upgraded. Only the first one is getting upgraded. It's very important to get one of the stables upgraded, because your forest defenders also will change into tanks, and that will make your base much stronger. Currently, your cavalry is all of your cavalry is only Enlightenment Age, which is not quite strong. But you are upgrading, so it's quite okay. World Wonders, the Acropolis. The Acropolis is placed a little bit outside, and it reaches all three of the stables, as well as one bunker in total, and the Colosseum, as well as one garrison. That means one, two, three, four, five, six. No, this one probably also. I don't know. Let's say it reaches this also. So one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. 8 buildings, 8 from 11, I think, or even 12. That means 66%. That's quite okay, because most of the important buildings are reached, the depots or even stables and one bunker. These buildings are far more important to reach than the garrisons. So I think the Acropolis position is very good, due to the fact that there's quite no reason, or no. It's not bad if the enemy destroys it, because the effect stays completely active. You can't destroy the effect, only destroying the buildings which are affected. The Colosseum is placed a little bit outside, but I think over here are some traps, so we have on purpose a little bit space over here. It will reach nearly complete over the base, and so I think it's no bad position. At least we have the Versailles, and the Versailles has a really key location, I think, in his base, because obviously over here I think some enemy attackers will attack and get the free town center, because they think, hey, I can get some more stars because of the exposed town center. Let's attack from over here and then rally inside. And first, enemies are getting slowed down, and second, we see over here he has one gap between his walls and between the Versailles. That means here are obviously, I think, some traps. And so when the enemy tries to entrance the base over here, he will be surprised. And that's quite a cool fact. So I think the Versailles is also used in a good way at this base layout. The exploration, we see he has one complete line of forest over here and one second line. In total, that's quite some forest to explore, and you are a little bit behind the average. Oh, by the way, for your walls, with your walls you are above the average. That's really strong. Level 11 walls are really high if you are not a payer, and I don't think that you pay. It looks like you are an active player and farming your gold. Explorations. Yo, yes, I would recommend explore more forest, because your buildings are a little bit... not scratched, I don't know the word. They are so close together, you can spread them out and make it more hard to get for the enemy the 100% 5-star or 4-star win, at least. Using some bugs is not possible, because of the oil bug with the generals is what got patched. You're only using the street bug, so your street is not leveling. I'm not quite sure whether this is gunpowder or at least Enlightenment Road, but I think it's an Enlightenment Road due to the fact that you are nearly as high as I am, and your defensive buildings are also nearly at the same stage. So you are using the road bug to make the enemy underestimate you. In total, I can say this base is very well. We have some weaknesses at this base. Probably the gates, also these three gold locations, but these are only little things. The most things and the main aspects about this base are very, very, indeed very good, I think. So cool base, my friend. Hey, yo, Daddy P, here we are at your base. Cool symmetrical base. It reminds me a little bit about a Chinese lotus, a flower. I think it's called lotus. But nevertheless, it is definitely a resource protection base due to the fact that we see the exposed town center. Where are the resources? We have gold over here, food over here, and trade goods over here, as well as the command post. So we have all severe or important buildings protected. Always we have two buildings paired up, nearly always, in one chamber, but they are separated, so we see never in no case two times the same building in one chamber. That's quite good, and we have also a very good spread around, because we see the food is at the right bottom corner, left bottom corner, and left top corner. Gold is center, right, also center and left bottom. So the spread around is good, because you have to kill completely the complete base or to get right around the base to get all of the resources of one kind. So this is definitely solved in a good way, I would call it. Where we are? Russia or Mexico? Sorry, I'm a little bit tired, guys. I had to yawn. I see one very severe point. He's upgrading two main defensive buildings. First recommendation of me is, don't ever, never, ever upgrade two of your mortars simultaneously, because if you have two of your mortars upgrading and they are not working, I think it's very attractive to attack you, because only two mortars are harming or endangering me. So I would only... upgrade one mortar, but if you want to upgrade two, it's just your thing, you can do what you want. But if you are upgrading, just place them outside, put any other building inside, but not upgrading defensive buildings. They have no more sense than even a house or some kind of farm, because they can't shoot or can't react to enemy attacks. Russia or Mexico, we see most of the buildings industrial as well, or even enlightenment. Only the garrison is... gunpowder as well over here, but garrisons are probably the weakest defensive buildings in the game, so you don't have to estimate them too high, so it's quite okay. I think he's a maxer, which is quite good. Activity index, where we have the houses, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 houses, so the maximum amount. Except for the estate, I don't see. Yes, and we have level 9 as level 9. Yes, thank you guys. Sorry, level 9 as well as level 10 walls at the outer side, And I think the choice of walls was quite great, because I'm always recommending if you have stronger walls, put the stronger walls to the outside. Only if you have double wall layers, then put the stronger ones to the inner side. That's quite good. We also see the gates are at level 9, that's weak. Level 9, 9, 11, really cool. 9, weak. Level 12 or even 13, quite good. Level 9, weak. In total, wow, level 12 wall, one level 12 wall, cool. I think he tried out whether to see how they look like. In total, your gates are too low, definitely too low, my friend. You have to upgrade them, in my opinion. These ones are already upgraded. Probably you are currently upgrading them, so everything is okay. Otherwise, I recommend to you upgrading them. Defensive buildings. The mortars are also placed very symmetrical over here. They are not as close as possible together, because we have not four distance over here, but five distance between every mortar. But that's only due to symmetrical reasons. That means in total it could be a little bit more effective from the location, but the location is now quite okay. The onlyest problem I see is over here. The mortar is definitely unprotected from the outer side and very easy reachable. Same over here, same over here. Only over here could be placed some traps, only. In the other ways, quite not. And that means I think the protection of the mortars is not that good. Even when this base layout looks quite really good. The compensation of weaknesses. Wow! Compensation of weaknesses is very, very well done, in my opinion. We have always a mortar cannon tower combination. Nothing to say about, just straight perfectly, I would call it. Air defenses. Where we have the air defenses? Oh, that's weak. One, two air defenses. Both. Not upgraded, so one air defense in total missing, and Z2 you have are first not upgraded, second very very exposed. I think the air defense factor is the most the weakest factor about your base. Your whole base seems quite okay, but the air defense is, I won't call it ridiculous, but it's even not existence, because if you are attacking from over here, you get one of the air defense instantly, and then the complete base over here has instant, except for some towers, which are not that bad for aircrafts, no air defense. That's a really harmful, dangerous factor for your base. Redoubts. Over here, here, and over here. So they are all placed at some corners. By the way, the whole base seems to consist only out of corners. That's really funny. But this is quite okay, because at corners the redoubts are placed very good. But I think these both redoubts are placed much better than this one, because we have some, wait, come on, some gates over here. So enemy troops are getting attracted by your own defenders, and your own defenders can't fly above your wall, so they have to use the gates. And when they are fluctuating through the gates, they are drawing enemy attention and triggering them or catching them into the range of the redoubt, which triggers the redoubt and then killing all of the enemy troops. So these ones are quite perfectly placed, I would call it. This one quite okay. In total, very okay. Nothing to accomplish, I don't know. Nothing to say it's bad about. Sorry. So the bunkers. Where are the bunkers? Outside unprotected. Does he has a second bunker? Or did he has not built it? I'm not quite sure. I think I can't see it. But I think there is no second bunker. Yes, I don't see anyone, any second. So he has only one bunker, which is quite weak, I would call it, because this one is also not upgraded. And bunkers are, I think, one of the most essential buildings which are significant for the industrial age due to the strong defenders. This bunker is a little bit, not a little bit, it is unprotected due to the fact that it is not inside the walls. But we have a perfect protection with this cannon tower. So the location of the bunker, I would call it okay. The protection is good, but the location is not that good because of exposing or being exposed. Sniper tower is definitely at the inner side, very central. Good location, you can't reach it from the outer side. Nothing to complain about. Complain! That was the word I searched for. Nothing to complain about this base. World Wonders, we have the Versailles again. Hanging Gardens. Brandenburg Gate and the Colosseum. Colosseum is placed at the complete outer side. I don't want to call this position bad, but there is indeed no worse position than this one, because you can't place it more to the outer side, so you can't waste the effect more. Nevertheless, the Colosseum effect will nearly cover half of the base, so it's okay, but you can definitely place it stronger. See, Versailles is also placed at the outer side, no obviously meaning, only as some enemies which try to get the town center are getting surprised by the slowing down effect. So the Versailles has a little effect, but only for the town center, which is quite not important at all in the industrial league, in the silver league, sorry. So the resources are not protected by the Versailles, I think, and so I think the effectiveness is quite nearly to zero. In total, I have to say this base looks very great. Very great. But there are some severe weaknesses, especially the reachability of three mortars from the outer side, and you can be sure there can't be placed any traps. But nevertheless, there are some improvements you could do about your base, but in total the base is quite okay and quite thought about. Here we are at epileptic. Oh no! Oh, sorry, not epileptic. Eclectic, I think. Sorry, my friend. That was not my intention. Global Age player, I see. Also a very symmetrical base. Town center exposed. So, resource protection. Let's analyze. Where are the resources? We see gold inside, oil obviously, which is always inside. Three times food inside, but where are the other gold? Over here we have some gold. Okay. He has no troops outside. Oh, only some Royal British. Because if he would have his troops outside at his barracks, we could analyze whether his troops are upgraded. If his troops would be completely upgraded to Global Age, I don't understand why he has his mills protected instead of his gold, his markets. But if he is currently upgrading his troops, I can just understand why he is focusing on the mills instead of markets. But we can't say anything about. The first thing, which is just coming to my mind, hey, this bunker is inactive. He forgot about refilling oil. This one is upgraded, but you see the light in the entrance. Here is no light, so this bunker has not paid its bills, so it got deactivated. Activate your bunker, my friend. No tanks will be spawned, but that's only a little side notice I recognized. Defense, yes, resource buildings. We have two resource buildings outside protect outside unprotected. Mills are protected, all of them in different chambers. Gold also in another chamber, and oil also. Where is the trade good? Trades good, store, resource, house, whatever. Here we have also unprotected. In total, I would call the locations quite okay. The spread around is not that good because you can reach two of them easily. And the total amount of protected resources is not that good because we have only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 out of 6, 7, 8, 9 buildings. That's nearly only the half of all. Rusher or Maxer? We see level 150 something. And most of the buildings are industrial, I think. Also some Enlightenment Age, so probably you can call him a rusher, but at the other side he has upgraded most of his important buildings. So the cannon towers are all upgraded, all of his mortars, most of his towers, the stables, one, two, where's the third? Three upgrades. So the most important buildings are upgraded, so I would call him a maxer instead of a rusher. Activity index. I don't see any house at all. Oh, over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 houses. No estate again. Cool. So maximum amount of ordinary working power. Level 9, at least some level 8 walls for a global player. And especially in comparison to the players we saw before. This is definitely behind the average. Yes, I would call it behind the average. Defensive buildings, yes, defensive buildings at least. The mortars are very, very outside, my friend. I see two unbelievable weaknesses. First one, completely outside your mortars. They are very easy reachable. And the second thing is we have only three space between them. So If I want to harm you, I just attack from over here, place one sabotage, and when the castle is gone because of the fact here can't be any traps, I just rally over here and my troops will get rid of all of two of your mortars, so 50% of your mortars before the attack has started completely. So that is a very severe weakness of your base, and it's just a fusion out of two weaknesses, the being exposed of the mortars and the location with which is quite too close together. Compensation of weaknesses is quite okay over here. Nevertheless, we have the cannon towers complete unprotected, so they will fall in an attack very early. Over here we have no protection at all for the mortars. I would call this compensation of weaknesses in total weak. It's not there, not existent. Air defenses. The air defenses are very central and one of his main aspects, obviously. I think his eclectic made some bad expectations, not expectations, some bad experiences with enemies which are using just bombers to get his oil, so he decided to focus on air defense. But what I can't understand, he is global age, has 4 air defenses, but none of this is upgraded. He can upgrade his all of them once more and then a second time more before they are maxed out. So his air defenses are located quite good, but very in total very weak. You also can just disable them. Oh, sorry, I searched for the word. Disable them with 2 sabotars, because they are so close together, even all over here. Redoubts. This redoubt is at the side. It's okay. It's not completely corner, but it's nearly a corner. This one is good. Really good. It's at the corner. Also, same over here. Same over here. The gates. Now I ask you something. Why have you put your gates over here? Only to get the space and to close your wall, but these gates have no sense at all. Why shall some troops run into here and picnic and then go back again? Same over here. Here's only one gate. Which troops will fluctuate over here? I don't think that this is very sensible, but okay. Bunkers. Both of his bunkers are exposed, and we see again, like I mentioned before, this bunker is inactive, so he got I think Eclectic is inactive in total. First, yes, he's an inactive player, we can look it up later. His resource buildings are completely empty. That means he has no not anymore, or even a very, very little amount only of resources inside his buildings. That's the first aspect we mentioned. Second aspect, one of his bunkers is inactive and you have to get attacked at least 5 or even 6 times before, and your bunkers, your tanks have to get stolen or destroyed. Then you have to refill, and after 5 or 6 stolen or destroyed tanks, your bunker will get inactive if you don't refill it. That's the second sign for being inactive. And the third sign is there was no new season to start, but nevertheless Eclectic has no league in which he is. That means he has not played since the last season ended, and these are 3 really really obviously signs that he is probably inactive. I only recognized it now. Former I did not recognize. So the bunkers are unprotected at the outer side. I don't like this very much, but we have good protection due to the cannon towers, which are quite close to them. In total, I don't like these positions due to the being exposed. Sniper tower. One. Okay, we have only one sniper tower in total, I think. This is placed okay. It's not protected, but it's okay. But it's not upgraded. He would have the possibility for 2 sniper towers, but he has only one, which is unprotected. So not very good in total. World Wonders, we have Acropolis, Colosseum, Versailles. Versailles is placed... It's placed okay, but I don't think why, or I don't know why any enemy should attack from over here. So I don't think there is a special reason about this. Colosseum is placed okay due to the fact that you just cannot place it in a bad way instead of placing it complete to the forest. And the Acropolis is behind the town center to trigger one garrison at least, command post, two garrisons probably, and three all of his stables. So the position of the Acropolis is quite okay. In total, I want to say, we have a very active alliance over here, a very engaged alliance, which is thinking about their base layouts before placing or building them. But this base layout was, until now, the one which I disliked the most, because there are very many aspects to be improved. I don't have anything against you, Eclectic, but there are some severe weaknesses at your base, and your alliance members, which we visited before, were quite better, so the expectations are quite high for your alliance. Let's go on. Oh, I had to return. We forgot about two aspects. We see over here two complete lines of forests. That means he has not explorated that much, especially because he is in Global Age. You also see, because all of his buildings are very close together, he nearly has no place at all. So there's he really needs to explore more forest. That's a really high recommendation. Also, he's using no bugs. He's only at level 159 due to the fact that his roads are upgraded. In total, his defense is not that strong. Now let's go on to the last one. Okay, here we are at King James, also a co-leader. But this base indeed does not look very good. And also, before, I already told you, some bases I don't want to visit and to analyze, because I don't want to insult anyone. But over here we see gold food is completely unprotected, oil also. He has unprotected everything completely. Here is no protection, and we see only one resource building which is protected. We see his town center is protected, but he's only at silver 1, so even the gold league, which is completely above him, has no significant good league bonus. The silver league, which he is in, has quite only ridiculous league bonus, so it has no sense at all to protect the town center. Therefore, I think we'll go on for a probably a little bit better base. Hopefully you are not mad about me because of this decision. Here we are at Crash, the next co-leader, and this base indeed looks much more thought about, I think. Resource protection base, Forbidden City, as well as main town center, both are exposed for focusing on the resources. We have one central chamber in which we have two mills, two markets. Oil is over here, trade goods over here, and another chamber for gold and food. This chamber is quite okay. This chamber for trade goods also, for oil also, but this chamber is very vulnerable due to the fact if you just easily fuck... Oh, sorry, that was the wrong word. Crash. Sorry, guys. Crash this piece of a wall, which is a connection piece, you have access to all mills, all markets. I don't think I have to say anything about this. This is quite weak for protecting your resources in total. Also, the spread out is very weak, because if you attack over here, you get instant access to both markets. And if you get inside here, you have instant access to all mills, all markets, all everything. And also to the oil, so not very thought about. Rusher or Maxer, we see many industrial buildings, also Enlightenment, but also Gunpowder. In total, I would call him, he's a hybrid form. We have one, two, three garrisons, one redoubt, which is quite not maxed, but we see quite not maxed in Gunpowder Age. So also not Enlightenment, but we have also some industrial max buildings. So he is in Industrial Age for a longer time without upgrading the buildings which are quite behind. So I think we call him a rusher. Activity index. One house, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eight houses. That's quite good. But the walls are at level 8. Some four walls at level 9. In average, and especially in this average of a very active War Machine 2 alliance, he's definitely below the average. Defensive buildings, where we have the mortars, over here, 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 and here. We have two severe problems. First severe problem, this mortar is getting upgraded and inside the base, so very useless. Put it outside, change it with another functional defensive building. Then we have the next severe problem, we have three out of four mortars exposed to the very outer side. The next third problem, these post mortars are too close together. Easily get rid of them with one disable, with one sabotage to disable both of them. In total, weak mortar positions, because every one you can get from outer sight, as well as this one. But this one is indeed the best protected mortars of all of them. Weakness compensations. None. So weak. Sorry, but it's weak. When I want to explain it, we have the cannon towers over here, but they are too close or too central in your base. They are that much in the inner side that they can only shoot if the enemy is already inside your walls. And when the enemy breached into putting protection on his troops, or even probably Strange of the Gladiator, blitzkrieging your complete base, your base is done. And then your cannon towers can't forget about shooting, so the location is not that good. It's only working for some radars which are trying to get your oil. Only in this case. Air defense, where we have the air defense, we have one, two, again, only two air defenses, so the last one is not researched. Both of them are not upgraded, and one of these two is exposed. This one is also at the outer side, but it can protect this mortar. In total, this can fall very easily, and when the enemy attacks from over here, nearly half of the base has no air defense. That means air defense is a really weak aspect about this base. Redoubts. This redoubt is at the corner. Very good location, I like this. This redoubt is in the center. No spawning buildings in this in the next surrounding. Only one bunker and a stable. But this guy, his tanks from the stable, cannot get into here because here is no gate. There's no other way to get outside. So this redoubt is completely wasted over here. This redoubt is very good. Wow. I would probably call this a perfect location. We have so many defender spawning buildings around. Then we have two gates where they can fluctuate, and we have a corner. This is a perfect example for a readout, I would call it. It's very perfectly here. It's a really dangerous readout, really. Where is the last readout, by the way? Okay, we called it 1, 2, 3. There we have bunkers. One bunker very central at the inner side, and the second bunker is not existent. It's not there, okay? But this one over here is really strong because it's protected quite good. But we have no cannon tower, only this one. But 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm quite sure this cannon tower cannot shoot instantly at a tank which is getting stolen by the enemy. So I think it's in the same point, one of his biggest strength, but also one of his biggest weaknesses about this base. The central, my mobile phone fall down, sorry. This central bunker, which is very strong, but also very unprotected. Sniper tower. This sniper tower position is definitely okay. You are completely unable to reach it from the outer side. This is probably the best located building, the best located defensive building in this base. But nevertheless, this guy is not upgraded, so it could be stronger. World Wonders. This is not significant for the defense. This is not built. This is significant, this one not. So we have to talk only about one building. And over here we have two garrisons, one stable, another garrison, and also a stable, but it's too far away. So only over here we have some very interesting healing aspects. Problem is only if the enemy attacks from over here, the Angkor Wat will be destroyed very early in the game, and then the effect also gets destroyed. Not like the Acropolis or the Versailles, which effects are staying active. Nevertheless, it gets destroyed. So I think the Angkor Wat position is not that good. It affects some building, yes, but it gets destroyed very early in the game. And it affects also not all buildings. The using or the exploration, we have one complete line over here, two additional forests, and one complete line over here. In total, he's missing about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 16 forests from above, I think 40. In total, something about 40. That's definitely not a huge exploration. You can also see, because all of his defensive buildings are as close as possible together, or nearly as close as possible. He has very, very little space only and is probably not able to build all of his buildings. So definitely recommendation, explore and get more area so you can make it more harder for the enemy to get 100%. Bucks using, he's not using any bucks at all. He's at level 149, but his defense is quite weak. He's only that high due to the fact that he has upgraded his roads. In total, I think this base is also very, you can optimize it really easily due to some severe effects which are weak currently. But I hope I could help you with my recommendations. We saw four bases today. Two of them I would call very good, very thought about. And two of them I would call with some huge improvement potential. But in total and overall, I would say all of these bases have quite some facts or some aspects to get improved. If they are now tiny or very, very huge on many aspects, it doesn't matter. There's nearly every base which can be improved a little bit. So guys, hopefully this video was quite entertaining for you. If you want that I come and visit your alliance and give you some feedback, some recommendations, give me some specific information about your alliance, the correct spelling of your alliance, some information about your medal count, your glory count, members, how many members you have, probably how your clan logo looks, so that I can more easy find you and don't have to search that long. So guys, we'll see you soon. Your domination tips.